13 love, 13 wisdom, 13 knowledge, and 13 respect, 13 to know. Niggas, serving ass. Check this. You know the other video I just did, and how I was sounding and stuff, right? So I had to go wash my face and everything and stuff like that. But check this out. And I told my daughter had made a little drink thing, or she got in the drink things from the first store. And it's a lot of different stuff. You know, I let her get what she wanted to get. And when she gave me something, she put it in the cup, Dad, I got you something. So I had to go get the container to see what was in it, because I know my body. I know when something is not right. I'm not feeling so bad. I'm like, oh my God, what is this? So this thing is called, it's a original superfood, right? So it says 1/4 mango, 1/4 juice of an apple, spirulina, 1/6 of a banana, 3.5 strawberries, 1/4 of a peach or whatever, right? No, it's not for concentrated, say. No sugar added, none of that stuff. No, shake it up and say vegan and everything, right? Check this out. So I'm looking, I'm like, oh wow, good kind of plastic bottle and all this kind of stuff. Just looking like, oh voila, superfood. Original superfood, premium fruit smoothie blend. I'm just like, whoa. No, I'm like, but something's not right. Right. And I keep reading, then I get to the back and I go and read. I'm reading. I'm reading the ingredients. Me and my daughter and I were talking to them when she got up in the AM. I read the ingredients and I see apple juice, peach, mango, strawberry, and banana, purees, spirulina. And then I saw something that blew my mind. Soy lecithin. I said, oh my gosh. And I said, vitamin C, ascorbic acid, wheatgrass, barley, grass, wheat sprouts, Jerusalem artichoke, lemon bioflavonoids, and Nova Scotia dulce. And then it got to the last word, is guess what it said? Contains soy. I almost threw up. But my body got rid of it that fast. I mean, my nose started running and stuff. And my eyes started running and everything. I was like, wow, my body don't play. I don't know if you see the video. I was like feeling, you see, I was getting worse at the end of the video. And so like, man, what the hell? I feel like I was gonna fall out. Man, my body don't play. That's a goddamn shame calling it vegan. Soy could have been vegan if it was organic, but hey, whatever. I don't want no soy. Not your boy. Don't want no soy. So that's why I was like that in another video. And it was good too. I know something had to be wrong with this junk. So that's up to you. If you drink that stuff, if you like organic soy, that's what it said, is organic soy. That's up to you. I don't do soy at all. And my body do not take it. So let me see what I can talk about. But so let me get on and talk about some other stuff right now. You know, when I tell you to let stuff go and on how you can like you detach from the old to get something new, that also goes back to like your religious people, like this is what ancestors say. You have to forgive those who have done stuff to you. You ain't gotta continue mess with them out there and doesn't bother you, but it's the thing like this, that you forgive, how they say, like toss them, like forgive, because you asking your father, and how you say father, which art in heaven, something that name, or you know what I'm talking about, right? But you ask for forgiveness of yourself and the things that you did wrong, right? But only how you get forgive if you forgive. Do that make sense? You want somebody to forgive you of everything you done bad, but you don't want to forgive other people for what they done bad to you. You see what I'm saying? This is what this has been relaying to me. Too many people out here holds on to being hate and grudges against somebody that they done something. Still, some of y'all still mad at somebody who stole your candy bar in the sixth grade. Look at Jeffrey over there. Like that motherfucker. Why you like him, man? I ain't never like that boy. You're 25 years old, you still mad at that dude in the sixth grade. Man, it was something. Fuck you, man. You know you stole my candy bar. I was hungry that day. Goddamn motherfucking candy bar thief. You know, some of y'all out there like that. Some of y'all are lost some good friends over some petty crap. You can't forgive nobody for nothing. Some of y'all still mad. Talk about, I see people here still posting all this stuff about some slavery crap and stuff. You, come on. How can you, if, listen to me. you want somebody to forgive you for whatever you undone, then you must forgive others for whatever they undone. This is just words of the ancestors. You don't have to forget, but you should forgive. You can't take that heavy heart with you, having hate on somebody. You gotta let it go. So if you want the Most High to forgive you of your dirty deeds, you must also forgive others of theirs. They'll get deal with theirs. They got to deal with their own stuff. But you cannot carry that heavy heart and that heavy burden. The laws of Maya don't like that. So you must forgive others for what they undone. And then you can be forgiven for what you undone. So like I came out of video and told her, I forgave all the people who hated on me. I made a video. Some of them still keep coming and hating. I don't see them no more. I'm not have to forgive them no more because I already gave my peace out. Anybody come after that, that's done. That's them. They done. I've said my peace. You know what I mean? I forgave everybody. Like, oh yeah, I ain't gonna kick it with you. But I forgive you. Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. Come three or four times and watch what I do to your ass. It's real talk. But ancestors also saying like, you gotta be that sun inside of you. You gotta shine from within. Everything starts from within. When you get ready to go to your job or go to your school or go wherever you're going on a date, you start getting dressed in the house. So you get your best inside the house. You put on your good looking shoes inside the house, and then you step outside. So it's the same thing out here in your body. You gotta do everything from inside, baby. And then bring it outside and let everybody see. And let everybody see you glowing, because you got to get your glow from inside and bring that outside of you. I told you this, but ancestors just emphasizing now to me. So once you start showing your light from inside of you, your light is going to be so bright, others will be attracted to you because you will be the light for them. So when you step inside a building, you will be that light. Like if all the lights is off, the thunderstorm hit all the lights off his door, you will be that lamp that everybody want to come around because you don't want glowing up inside the place. So you gotta bring that light from inside of you and start shining out here. Everything starts from inside. Stop looking outside for stuff first and then trying to take it back inside of you. Because you don't wanna bring stuff from outside of you and bring it inside of you. Like, that's why I talk to your soul. And that's why so many resonate with me, because I hit the soul. Because namaste, the soul was inside of me, speaks to the soul that's inside of you. Some of y'all get mad at me and hate me, but you still gotta keep coming back to listen for more. You know why? Because it's your soul that's coming back. You still calcified because you still on the outside of yourself, but that invisible soul is what talking to the spirit that knows my spirit and know who I am. You still might be confused, but the soul inside of you knows the truth, because the spirit, the divine, is the invisible, is the unseen, is inside of you. That's the same invisible unseen that leaves your body when you astral travel. That's the same spirit, that divine, that can come out of your body at will. That's that 21 grams of light. Some call them angels, some call them angels. But it's your soul, and it's the divine. It's just ancestors talking through me, baby. So you gotta get your pilot light and let it start shining and glowing. I was going through with the thing, I had wrote some stuff too. I was trying to explain how people know how stuff tell people, like, even in laws of Maya, you don't supposed to go sleep with nobody else's wife. So that's like adultery and stuff, right? And that's bad that you already got your wife, but you go sleep with somebody else's wife and all this kind of stuff. You know, you mess up another happy home because you're not happy, because you're in your lustful ways and you're in that temptation ways. You're doing all that evil stuff like that, right? But I found out that ancestors say, You committed adultery at just with your eyes also. So if you eye somebody down, like, ooh, God damn, I like to get upside of that. Damn. You know, you still, I'm just using the word sin, like they say it, but you still get the heavy heart with that lustful eye that you just did, because you still looking outside of your home as something else, and you lusting for that. That temptation. You don't supposed to be doing that. That's why I can look at my sisters around me and don't pay no kind of attention, have no kind of like no sexual fantasies about her. I can call them all my queens, my sisters, my sea stars, and I'm not paying no attention to them. Because I'm above that level. I'm not down there on that level. Like, ooh, shoot, call it, hit that there. I'm not gonna beat the brakes off, you know, not that there. See, people not on that. A lot of my partners know me from back in the days when I used to have like a van full of girls or whatever, take them to the club, whatever, that's what I did. When they saw my van pull in the parking lot, all sporty and stuff, be like, man, that's that party van. And you see them with a bunch of females stepping outside, and I'm in that captain's seat. And everybody wanna get in, they're like, damn, I bet you be getting all of them. And they ain't have a goddamn clue I was a businessman. I always kept one bad one with me, you know what I'm saying? But you know what I mean. But I had the best around me everywhere I went. And everybody thought I can go to anybody's house, and I'm so tired sometimes because I used to run the street so much, up for days, you know what I'm saying? And I come to the house and I go in there, they got their boyfriend, they have a little party going on, they give me the keys to their bedroom, whatever. I go in there and fall out, get knocked out for 16 hours or something, they won't let nobody disturb me. These are the kind of people, females, that I know, because they know who I am. And the people like them, and boys might get jealous, man. I know, dang, your uncle, you sleep with him, so that's my uncle. And we ain't got blood uncle, but it's the uncle from that soul side. And that's why people uncle out here now. Because I can go places and I can let people let me rest my head because they know I'm good. They know I'm not going to flip to the sexual attentions and stuff because I was above that level. But all my other partners, they couldn't, they were some ooh-wee boys. You know, they came into the strip club, and I'm sitting up there at the manager and stuff like that. We chilling. They come, ooh-wee. The wee boys, they want to see they wasn't on that level, and they wonder why I got invited to the girls' parties and all that other kind of stuff, because they know I wasn't gonna come and go ooh wee, you know, that horny self, you know what I'm saying? I know I was taught from females. I was taught not to show my cards, no way, no how. Never go nowhere no showing no horny card, because if you go in with a horny card showing your hand, you're gonna get cashed in. You gotta pay to play, babe. Let me get off that there. But I'm being honest. So you gotta stop being reckless eyeballing people out here. Because that is not good. So y'all looking up you up and down at your sisters and stuff out here. Your sisters are just your sisters and your daughters. Your daughters are your mothers. So when you reckless eyeballing everybody out here, that's heavy hard. I'm giving to you what the ancestors are telling me. And the only thing we out here doing now, we out here showing twerk videos and everything, so everybody got this reckless eyeball going on. Y'all have no respect for yourself. You have no respect for your daughters. You have no respect for your sisters, for your mothers, your aunties. I see some people saying that's my cousin, but I get her. I know cats like that out here. I know cats watch their mama walk by. Man, my mama got a fat ass. And they friends sitting around and not there, ooh boy, your mama got a fat ass. What kind of crap that is? I chop your head off and bury you inside. I put your head on a hood on it and drive around town. They just, man, what kind of car that is? A Negro peeing. Goddamn nappy head Negro peeing on the front of my car. Goddamn, where you get that from? I got that at the hood. Disrespect my mama or something like that, sister. And I'm serious. See, I already knew I was a different person. That's reckless eyeballing. So y'all gotta stop doing this reckless eyeballing out here. Yes, there's some beautiful woman out here and that they can turn your head and stuff like that and jump like that, but you can't lust for them. You gotta start respecting them as who they are. Because big I'm a mama. You don't wanna be doing reckless eyeballing. Them daughters vert. See what I'm saying? A lot of people are gonna be losing their souls over this stuff. Their heart gonna be too heavy for this stuff. They left outside their temples and started chasing other stuff. I'm trying to tell y'all this stuff, man. I've been writing all this kind of stuff down for days and stuff. Man, it's about having a real pure heart. That heart has to be pure. No free heart. You know, a lot of people don't have their hearts are not pure. They holding on too much stuff. Stuff that you cannot change. You cannot change it. Just like your bill collector, your tax collector, something like that. You know, has one of the other sayings, what it say, forgive those debts as we forgive our debtors, whatever, right? Now, you want somebody to forgive you of your debts, but you don't want to forgive nobody else of their debts. Somebody owe you $20, you still mad at that person.
Man, I left over 20 some G's out there in the streets gone. God, way more than that, but I'm just saying, I left, nothing I can do. What I supposed to do, keep getting mad at your cuz, what's up, man? Hey, can I get that? I mean, I got out the joint. I saw a cat driving a little thing, Benz and stuff, called me at the liquor store, little hookers and stuff. Got a little bottle and stuff. What up, cuz? Where you still feeling good now? Oh, what's up, man? Putting out a big knot, probably got about 14 stacks on him or something like that. You know, I'm like, God damn, boy, look at you doing good, ain't you? You know, I said, yeah, boy, you know, I'm getting it. I said, yeah, well, can I get something? Can I get something? Hey, I had to get out and pay them debts. I took care of them debts because I had it. I don't want no, he's coming to chop my head off or come mess with my family or nothing like that. You know, that's how the game go. When you keep it real. But nah, I ain't got it up. Man, I ain't got it, man. I said, what you mean that's old? Nigga, I got you, bond. You out of jail, pay your lawyers and everything, and you talk this old. Nigga, I fronted you. I ain't gonna get out of jail. You know what I mean? Shoot. Back in the day, you throw around 125 like it ain't nothing. You know, that ain't nothing. You know, nowadays, you know, people out here think they doing something. That shit was nothing. Y'all Florida people know what I'm talking about. You niggas know. Man, shoot, man, Port of Miami, it was Port of Tampa, you know, we brought water, that's all I can say. Let me get off them doors, but I'm saying, I forgave them people, right? But I still know how the karma still hit them. I remember it wasn't even a week when the dude, I was like, damn, dog, I said, man, just give me, shoot with $200, call it even. Just 200, that's it, that's all. Man, let me go to college tomorrow. But tomorrow ain't gonna come because he got busted. He got busted with them little hookers on going to Orlando drinking on the little turnpike with eight balls, whatever they got in the little benzo, trying to outrun the police. You can't outrun no walkie-talkies no more. But karma got him. That's just how people do, cause I come to him with an open heart and a clean heart. I forgave people that snitched on me. I forgave my own brother snitching on me and stuff like that. I forgave him. I mean, when I was getting out of that, that's coming back through Orlando and stuff, people like, hey, man, hey, like, hey, come on. They're like, man, hey, man, everybody scared. Because, you know, I'm a revengeful person. But I said, I don't see none of that in the past. I forgive everybody. I forgive you. I don't care what you did to them. I forgive you. You know, I've done my time. I forgive everybody. I forgive the government and stuff. I didn't go get my money from the military. I forgive everybody. I ain't gonna have that crap on my heart. That's when I turned myself to the 13. I didn't turn myself to the 13. That's when I started accepting who I am. That's why it was the best thing ever happened to me, to get me off the streets, because I got a chance to go in there and rest my body again. Build my body back up to 13 parts again, because I was breaking down out here, doing too much for every goddamn body. Then I started to stop doing for myself. And I hated being the 13. But then I accepted who I was, because I found out who I was. And I knew who I was, and ain't nobody can stop me now. But I forgave every single body. I forgave them. And that's when I got my torch lit all the way up inside of me. And everybody see me walking, see glow around me. When they see me walking, they should move, they see trees walking with me. It's real talk. Shoot. So let stuff go out here. Cause people still out here hating on stuff that ain't really, they didn't hit them directly personal. Like some dude out telling people that posted all these people hanging from trees, like the hung and the slave, all that bullshit like that. You can't change that. That ain't gonna make you better. That's only gonna make you mad and get a heavy heart. And once you got to hurt somebody, you're gonna end up in prison. And you're gonna leave your children out here with nobody to protect them. You can't do nothing about that stuff, so you gotta let it go. I was directly affected by that stuff, and I let it go. My granddaddy was hung and property stolen. Suddenly, people ain't had nobody in their goddamn family, huh? They see some pictures and they're using something for excuse. They don't want to let it go. My daddy let it go and say, I'll show and prove. Oh, y'all didn't want us to buy nothing for your store? You got my own store. Oh, y'all want to send me no kerosene and stuff when it's cold? I get my own kerosene company. Oh, y'all said we can't move in the neighborhood? I'm going to move to the biggest house in the neighborhood with the pool. I'm gonna make you mad. That's what my dad did. Whatever they said he couldn't do, he did it. I was part of the people that really fought for that in the school segregation. This is gonna spot spanking. I did it for real. I was a little boy jumping out of the car with that. Pow, 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 pow. My brother fighting. There was so many of them, it's just a few of us. But we showed and proved. Now we done it for real. These people are here talking smack. When you got people that got white sheets on, all the stuff is right in front of your house. And it's only, I found the 13 of us. About 50 of them out there. Like you see in the movies. Oh, but they don't go down like that. Not when you got that ether all around you with them apostles. It didn't go down like that. But then you have some more, all those that come on outside, stand on outside with us and bring some guns too. And we tore ass up. So my daddy buried a bunch of them motherfuckers. Excuse my language, but I forgave them. I played with their children after that. Ain't got nobody else to play with. But it's the point that people out here be getting mad at stuff that wasn't directly, that was direct. I got machetes up in my head. So I was directly affected by all that so-called Jim Crow stuff that people talk about. So when people talk about, man, you still, no, they don't have a goddamn clue. They got a heavy heart and don't know how to grow from something, because you cannot grow from something if you hold it on to something. Only how you get something new if you let it go. That's the sixth law of the universe. That's the law of detachment. This is real talk, brother. I got a bunch of stuff I've been writing down here. You know, like people trespassing. You know, we always say forgive those who trespass and all that kind of stuff. See, we ask the Most High to forgive stuff like we do, that we have done, we trespass on people or whatever, but we don't want to forgive people who trespass on our stuff. We want to kill people out here now. They pass the law like somebody come on your property, shoot them and kill them, all this bull crap. See how Satan got everything messed up out here? It's real talk. Y'all got to learn. Y'all being tricked. Y'all being tricked. But you got to turn that light on the side of you, that lamp. Does lightning become from the ground up? I told them that, but they don't hear me though. But they become we text me after the questions and stuff. I get a lot of people, some people that I talk to and stuff. I get a lot of people be sending me messages and stuff. They got my number or whatever. And I got two phones and stuff anyway, but we look at my phone numbers and stuff, but people call the numbers. I don't answer the phone calls, but I see some of the text messages and stuff, and a lot of messages and stuff, but they be asking questions. And that's the last video I told you. You gotta start asking yourself first. See, ancestors, I gotta go. Ancestors keeps it real. But you gotta start forgiving others. And you really gotta forgive yourself. You want forgiveness of the stuff you undone in life? Nobody ain't out here perfect. You know what I'm saying? So you gotta really forgive yourself. And everything will start coming to you once you forgive yourself, but you also gotta forgive others. And you'll see how everything comes to you. People come to me now, just give me stuff, because they see the hard. They see the real true stuff. You know, I don't be out trying to bang your heads down. I'm gonna come at you like your uncle, your daddy, your brother, whatever. I'm gonna come like that big brother, like that. They'll show that real, to put some discipline in your ass, to get you to obey them laws. But it's up to you to take that and run with it. You know, cause I'm trying to make you better. I ain't trying to be better than you. I'm trying to make you better, so then you can make it resonate down to other people. All right, it's your boy, the Super Son, the Superman, 13 Love, 13 Wisdom, 13 Knowledge, and 13 Respect. Change your ways, baby. It's time to let it go. You know what I'm saying? I ain't saying forget everything. Just you gotta forgive and let it go to be rewarded with other stuff. Because the bigger man does that. Think about it. 13.